Okay. Mr. Taru here, continuing my new series of videos to help you learn how to use the TI-NSPIRE. I'm learning these as I go, so I have now I'm going to attempt to make a capture video off my computer with the faceplate just as an outline, because I realized it was very hard to see my black cursor pointer over the black calculator, which is how they look in real life. So let's see if this works any better. Please give me some feedback. Okay, we're going to make some more statistics plots. Today we're going to take a look at histograms, box plots, and dot plots. So we're going to open up a new document. We are going to have to add some data to the calculator if we're going to be able to make any graphs at all. So we're going to do four, add lists or spreadsheets. And with a TI-NSPIRE, you do need to name the columns as you put in the data. These are generic data just to, you know, show it as your calculator. So I'm just going to call this X. And we're going to come down here. Oh, and by the way, as you see this cursor move around, if you haven't seen one of my other videos yet, all this cursor moving, you would be putting your finger on the touchpad here and moving it around and pressing and pushing down the center of the touchpad and making it click. That's your selection process. Or you could hit enter. But if you want to select an item with your cursor, then you need to press down and actually make the center of that touchpad click. Okay, let's put in some numbers so we can just make a histogram and see what it looks like. So here, and of course you can do one. I'm going to put in some generic numbers, and I'm not going to keep moving my finger back and forth. I'm just going to use my number pad here on my keyboard. So we got a couple of ones, four twos, so two, 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 and we'll put in eight threes, one, two, three. All right, some fours, maybe three fours. Couple of fives, and six, six, and let's skip out and make sure we have a nice outlier here, 10 and 13. Okay, so we have some data in our calculator. How do we display that in a histogram? Well, once your data is in the calculator, in a list that you have named, and if you're working on in statistics, all these problems are related to real-life applications. It'd be nice if you actually typed the whole name in there, or at least enough to tell what the variable is and not just always a generic X and Y. Okay, to add a page on your calculator, you want to do Control, Page, and Add a Data or Statistics Page. It's number 5, so if you want, you can just come down here and hit 5, but if you're already using your cursor and you're up here, 5. Okay, so when you go to make a scatter plot, you get just a window of random points. We only put in one column of data, so this is univariate quantitative data, and we're going to come to the x-axis and click add a variable. And we only put one in, so not much to choose from. And just like that, everything starts to move around, and we have a dot plot. And I just put in whole numbers, very small. You can see it is a, make it look more like a right skew distribution. Let me add another 7 and 8 in here. So I'm going to go back to this first page. I can click here with my by moving my finger over the touchpad, or I can do control right click on the left click on the touchpad and move back one. And let's add in another 7 and an 8. And enter. And then come back here and you can with your finger on the touchpad hit 1.2 or control right click to move to the right. Now we got a nice right skew distribution and a couple of outliers, and this is a dot plot. If I want to change this to a histogram, I hit menu, plot type, and choose histogram instead of dot plot, which is what it's used right now. This is not highlighted, and that's what because it is a dot plot. Well, I guess I can't really say that because it's not a bar graph or pie chart either, but in this top section, this is your univariate quantitative data selections, and the dot plot is the current one. Let's make it a histogram. The histogram pretty much just makes a bunch of bars right over those stacks of dots. Histograms will have the classes touching to show no space in between those class intervals, since you don't want to leave any numbers out. An empty group is just a class that has no data in it. That's a lot of intervals. Now with a histogram, you do want to have about at least 5 intervals, and this is nice and I like it actually, but if you want to make this these intervals wider, you can hit menu and plot properties, and under histogram properties, let me hit the escape button, that window popped open too quickly. Under histogram properties, you can change the histogram scale from percents to density. This would be a relative frequency percents in statistics, that's called relative frequency. We want that to go back to counts. Actually, it doesn't really matter if it is or not, but I want to make sure, show you how to make that go back to counts. Plot properties, histogram, scale, and go to density. That is your, or frequency, excuse me, your frequency histogram. That's counts. Frequency is count. Relative frequency is percents. If I go back to menu again and go back to plot properties again, the bin setting will allow you to change the width of those bars. Now, I don't think a width of 2 is all that great for this set of data, and I don't know why I'd want my alignment to be 0.5 if I put all whole numbers in, so let's me make that 0 and hit OK. Well, now I still see this nice right skew distribution. The fact those were outliers is kind of hidden now, but the bar goes off the top of the screen, so you can hit Menu, Zoom, and fit it to data. And now here's our right skew distribution. Now with the counting by 2, you don't see how those were outliers like you did when the class width was 1. And sometimes that just happens. I didn't make them that far out. Made them as far out as I thought. And your decision on what the class width is going to be will, of course, as you can see, change slightly the look of your histograms. So that's how you make a histogram. And again, that is how you change the property bin and how you can change the width of your classes to, you know, show up, so to give you the number of bars you'd like to see in your histogram. Now, how do you make a box plot? Well, you might have noticed it was in that menu, plot type, box plot, and voila, we have a box plot. And with it showing the outlier, it is automatically doing the IQR test for us, the Q3 minus Q1 times 1.5. You get this number, you add it to Q3, and there's an upper boundary somewhere, and you subtract that from Q1 and get a lower boundary, and that IQR test is showing that this point out here is indeed an outlier like I intended it to be. If you do not want to make a modified box plot, you can hit Menu, Plot Properties, and then you can extend the box plot whiskers to all the data, so it's no longer a modified box plot, and you don't see the word modified box plot in these menus. Of course, you don't see that in 83 and 84 either. And you can come back here and show the outliers again. So, that is entering data and the three types of plot properties, dot plot, box plot, and histogram. Now, we put in right skew data. Normal probability plot we just studied recently, you want a normal probability plot to look approximately linear if the data is indeed normal, and clearly ours was right skewed. So let's make a normal probability plot and see what that looks like. So we had right skew distribution. Uh-oh, it's off the screen. Let's see here. Zoom, data. Well, that didn't seem to change anything. What's that about? I actually expected that to change. So I'm going to grab this axis over here. You'll do this by hitting the center of your touchpad key and grab it and scroll up till I see the rest of those values. I'm not exactly sure why I didn't fit the window to that. And again, you'll be using this pad. You'll come up here to where this symbol comes up, and you'll hold the center of your touchpad, get the little closed fist, and then pull down. Okay. So do you see how that data is indeed not linear? And you see the negative z-scores. Now, right now I have them set up to be on the y-axis. Those z-scores, those negative z-scores, are all tightly packed, and the positive z-scores start to become more and more spread out. Those positive z-scores, the data that was to the right of the mean becoming more spread out, well, that's what you have when you have a right skew distribution. And I actually sort of just keep toggling through all these types of graphs, so I was going to try and go back and show you the histogram, but I can't. So let's just do menu, plot type, histogram, and there's that right skew distribution that you saw in the normal probability plot that had the positive z-scores more spread out, and of course now it's running off the screen again. So there's how to do some univariate graphs on the the TI-NSPIRE. I'm learning this as well. Hopefully this blank screen is easier to see my cursor move around than the previous two videos I just published. If there's anything else you want to know how to do with this calculator, please send me a message, and if I do know how to do it, I'll post a video, as well as continuing that through the year. Thank you very much for watching. Mr. Tarrou is out.